7, 6, 5, 4.
They've broken on 5, earlier than they've ever jumped a gun before. Penske gets away just in front of Holbert. Pack into the first turn. Surtees leads Rodriguez. Gurney and Penske into the S's just in front of the famous Sebring first lap traffic jam. It's Rodriguez ahead down Warehouse Straight, but he can't make the turn. Surtees moves into the lead through Webster. Penske second. Rodriguez struggles back, but has dropped several places. McKelvey's Abarth is too deep into the turn, and he's not as lucky as Rodriguez. It's Surtees and Penske on the back straight. Look at Penske move. Penske's Corvette is by Surtees' Ferrari through the timer stand turn. And the young automobile executive takes the lead as they complete the first lap. Penske holds off Rodriguez and passes the start line in second place. The first Shelby Cobra running sixth with Dan Gurney at the wheel. Rodriguez has caught Penske on the turn and is now second to Surtees as they streak through the S's toward the hairpin. Rodriguez flat out passes Surtees heading into Webster. This is where he lost it on the first lap. But he's safely by. And it's Rodriguez, Surtees, Hill, Penske, and Scarfiotti through Webster. But starter Jesse Coleman has the black flag out for Pedro. Surtees inherits the lead as Rodriguez is forced to report to his pit. Underwood Porsche 904 is well at the top of the 2-liter machinery. Just behind is the half-sharp 904 and the number 43 Jennings Wester Porsche. Shelby's token entry in the prototype class, a standard Cobra stuffed with a huge 7-liter engine, hasn't been right since driver Ken Miles had an accident with it during practice. But the Gurney Johnson Cobra is running beautifully. First in Grand Touring and staying there with no trouble, handling well and showing great speed on the straights. Meantime, Chuck Castle moves his number 45 Abarth Carrera into the running in GT Division 2. The tiny 1-liter Renault Alpine, smallest car in the race, is in the same division as the Ferraris. The factory Alfa Romeo team with a 3-car entry hopes for a GT Division 2 win, although outpowered by the rival Porsches. The Daytona Cobra is in. MacDonald surrenders the car to Holbert, but not before some air conditioning is provided. Both men complained of the hot cockpit, but MacDonald had unusual trouble.
I can't keep my feet on the pedals. It gets pretty hot down there. Have to get some kind of shoe to keep the heat off. When I went out first, I used the wrong kind of shoes and I burnt the bottom of my feet, and now they get sore pretty easy. You know, the shoes I have are all right, except the bottom of my feet are already burned a little. But doesn't seem to be bothering Bob so bad.
The Penske Hall Corvette has settled down. After his spectacular dash at the opening, Penske is content to stay in the top 10, running behind Gurney and Holbert. Penske and Hall have trouble. Their mechanics are taking a half shaft from a stock Corvette in back of their pit. The half shaft broke while Penske was out on the course. According to the rules, he must walk back with the needed parts, with a pit steward along to see that his mechanic does no more than advise, as Penske makes his own repairs. It'll be an hour and a half delay. The overall Grand Touring Division race is all Cobra at the moment. The Kearney Johnson car is first GT uncontested, a solid fourth overall behind the Ferraris. Running second GT now is the number 14 Cobra with Phil Hill and French champion Joe Schlesser driving. And Shelby, with his cars 1, 2, 3 GT, doesn't want anyone burning them up. Shelby's Ferrari opposition in Grand Touring is a factory entry driven by Carlo Abbate and Luigi Cinetti's GTO driven by Piper, Gamino, and now Rodriguez. But both are overpowered by the larger engine Cobras. And the Bondurant Spencer Cobra is beginning to move through the pack after its teammate. The eight-cylinder prototype Porsche was doing well until an extended pit stay with clutch trouble. A.J. Foyt's trying to catch up too. After passing 50 cars on the first lap, he ran into an extended brake pad change. He's now 10th overall. Up front, the Hill Bonnier 4-liter Ferrari has taken the lead from Surtees late in the afternoon. The Surtees Bandini car, two laps behind at this point, presses after the lead Ferrari. The sun slipping lower as the long day's journey turns toward nightfall and the dangerous final hours of the race. Shelby's Cobras are still running soundly. The Gurney Johnson car is now fourth overall, first Grand Touring. Lights are on now as night settles quickly and lap time slows somewhat. Bandini has brought the lead car into the pits. Flickering taillights and a brake change, a perennial Ferrari weakness, make this the third nighttime stop and drops the 4-liter car to third place. Taking over first, Scarpiani Vaccarella with a Parks Maglioli Ferrari just behind. Less than an hour to go. Ferrari 1-2-3 overall. The Gurney Johnson fourth overall, first GT. There's been a crash. Johnson, driving the number 11 Cobra, has hit an Alfa Romeo at the far end of the pit. The Alfa, apparently in trouble, was barely moving in one of the speed lanes. Scarpiani and Vaccarella are first now. Parks Maglioli second. Surtees Bandini third. And the Holbert MacDonald Cobra fourth, first GT. And Mike Parks takes Jesse Coleman's checker to lead the Ferrari Blitz. Parks and co-driver Maglioli share the winner's spoils. Scarpiani and Vaccarella were second. John Surtees and co-driver Bandini third. But of greatest delight to the crowd was the tremendous Cobra performance. True to his hopes, Carroll Shelby whipped the Ferrari GTOs, taking the manufacturer's championship lead at the same time. Holbert and MacDonald led the GT winners and placed fourth overall, five laps behind the winning Ferrari.
Bob, congratulations. You got a big smile, another victory for you. How'd the car perform?
Oh, fine, Chris. It didn't miss a beat all day. Except we really had a steam bath during the day. It was pretty hot.
I noticed you made some modifications on it for bathing purpose. What did you do?
Oh, we just put a few vents in it to get a little more air into the car. We were actually, we had a steam bath and massage all at the same time earlier today.
The Bezetta Pon Porsche won GT Division 2. GT Division 1 went to the Abarth of Diaz, Fleming, and Linton. The Cunningham Underwood Porsche 904, the highest finisher behind Ferrari and Cobra.
The American public, with the introduction of American-powered cars and American-built cars now, is really beginning to flock to these races.
It was an American day for the first time in a long series of the 12-hour grind.